Hello everyone. Good afternoon. Akshay. Welcome to class. We are starting the rapid revision series for evolution. Most important. Can wait for few minutes, then I am starting with the first question. First of all, I am meeting all of you after a time. So how is the study going on? Shri Trisha, Shri Vidya, Akshya, Jivita and Pooja. What about the studies? How is the revision going on? So let's start the rapid revision series for chapter evolution. So I hope you have a good revision at home. We have different 30 questions, most important 30 questions from all the subtopics. We have chosen the question from every subtopic is covered here so that you have a proper revision of the whole chapter. So here is the first question on the screen. According to Hardy-Weinberg principle, one of the most important hypothesis or the law, or you can say equilibrium principle, which was given by Hardy-Weinberg, allele and the genotype frequencies in a population will remain constant. We know the Hardy-Weinberg principle, and it is constant from generation to generation in the absence of other evolutionary influence. There are not various changes. So the overall, can say allele frequency as well as the genotype frequency in a population is always constant, and it makes several assumptions which were given below, like random mating, sexual reproduction, known overlapping generation, occurrence of natural selection, and the small size of population. So what are the parameters which does not fulfill for Hardy-Weinberg principle? If there are a lot of changes in a population, then it will automatically affect the allele or the genotype frequency. So identify two assumptions which do not meet for a population to reach Hardy-Weinberg principle. What are the two assumptions which by which we cannot meet the criteria which are required for the equilibrium equation, that is P plus Q is equal to 1. See the formula. So it is random mating, sexual reproduction, known overlapping generations, or occurrence of natural selection. If there is occurrence of natural selection, then it cannot be constant. Yes, because in a natural selection, there are variations, struggle for existence, and all other parameters. And it's not applicable. Also, which do not meet small size of population. Yeah, Shri Trisha and Shri Vidya, read the question again. Identify the two assumptions which do not meet, or don't be in rush always. Always read the statement properly so that you are able to answer the question. What are the parameters which help in attaining a Hardy-Weinberg principle? Is it random mating, sexual reproduction, and known overlapping generation? But here it is saying which do not meet. So what is the answer? What should be the answer? These are the criteria which is helping to meet. So it should not be the answer. The D should not be the answer. So it is the occurrence of natural selection as the smaller size of population. Yes. Now you have given the right answer. It is A. Because if there is natural selection, that this genotype or the allele frequency cannot be constant from generation to generation. Okay, there may be variation, there may be changes in the frequency. Chances of occurrence of a particular gene at a particular loci, that is gene frequency. In terms of genotype, it is genotype. In terms of allele, it is allele frequency. the answer for the question number 1, it is A. Okay guys, there should not be any confusion with the Hardy-Weinberg principle. It is an important situation which need to be understand, and the related numericals also there are questions we are discussing in minutes. So answer for the question number 1, it is A. Okay, it's okay if you have confusion, but what I am assuming, you know the principle, but you have not written, have not got with this word. Do not meet. It is not which meet. If it is meeting, then the answer will be different. Okay, guys? So, occurrence of natural selection and small size of population do not meet the criteria for population to reach Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. For Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium to be reached, natural selection should not be occurring. Because during the natural selection process, the allele frequency, they continuously changing in a specific direction. But the assumption, main assumption for the Hardy-Weinberg principle is that the allele frequency is constant. And the another parameter is that the population size is very large. Because if the population size is large, then may or may not be effect of the small changes they are occurring in a population. So the answer is A here. A population in a Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium for a gene with only two alleles. The gene frequency of allele A. When we talk about Hardy-Weinberg principle, we always talk about two alleles. It is gene frequency for A is 0.7. The genotype frequency of AA is, I am waiting for the response, it is T square plus Q square plus 2PQ. Okay. What should be the answer? Genotype frequency of PQ is given by 2PQ. What should be the answer? I am waiting for the response. Here it is given 0.7. P plus Q is 1. Q is 0.3. 0.3 into 0.7 into 2. So what should be the answer? Yes. Yes, the answer is right. You are giving the right answer. Yes, yes, yes. And Shritita, the answer is right. 0.7 into 2 into 0.3, that is 0.42. Okay, your answer is right. So it is a direct question on this numerical, so we don't need so much of time. We can save the time and can use for explanation for the other questions. So this is clear with you. Select the option having correct sequence of geological periods. If we see, this is the question number 3 for all of you. If you see the geological periods, geological time scale, which is given for the evolutionary process for plant, microorganism and animals on earth, it is given in a sequence and it is divided into periods, era, periods and epoch. So what should be the geological period? Here it is given the period, which comes first, then second, then third. We see here it is Precambrian for pre-existing life, Paleozoic, then it is Mesozoic, Cenozoic. So Pira, what should be the periods? Pira, then periods, then epoch. Yes? So what should be the answer? Which comes first? Comes first? All of you have given the answer right in a way. Because in this question, if you see, this Jurassic, Permian, then Triassic, then Jurassic. If you revert the sequence, it is Jurassic, then Triassic, then Permian. But we will always go with the last. Okay, Permian, then Triassic, then Jurassic. So answer it should be A. Your answer is right, but we will always give the answer in this sequence. Okay guys, is it clear? Your logic is right. So we are moving. So if you see, for that Triassic, it is Permian. Okay. So here, Mesozoic, Paleozoic, Precambrian. You see here, it is Permian here. Okay. So we will always give the answer in this sequence. Okay, guys, always give from the, like, if chart is given from the bottom, here it is given like Permian, then Triassic, then Jurassic. The answer should be first. Logically, it should be first, but your sequence is right. But if the answer is not right, it will not work. So always think for attempting any MCQ. It is very, very important. The diagram given below represent Miller's experiment. Miller's experiment is one of the most important experiment which was given for the origin of life to explain experimentally the hypothesis which was given for the chemical evolution. Yes, it was given to justify the chemical evolution which was given by Oparin and Haldane. So choose the correct combination of labeling. Okay, choose the correct combination of labeling. So take your time and answer correctly. Okay, take your time but answer correctly. Like for A, they are asking for A, B, C, E and D. So 5 markings are here. So in this setup, what were there? There were a mixture of gases in this apparatus. So B can be the mixture of gases. And again, I am saying the NCERT diagrams, as this is a revision time for you guys. So I am taking a minute and giving you an advice. NCERT diagrams of each and every chapter must to learn, must to follow with their labelings. So sometimes the labeling is missing. Sometimes the false labeling is given. Sometimes they have modified diagram somehow. So what should be the answer? B is for mixture of gases for sure. It is a U-turn from which the product was taken out. Okay. A, these are the two electrodes as we can see here also. So if you see, A is given electrode in all the four choices. B is given for gases in all the choices. C is the cold water. D is the vacuum provided. E is the U-turn. So answer should be A. The answer should be A. Pooja Kashyap, answer should be A. Hey, Shri Vidya, and I am waiting for the response. Is it clear? Is this diagram is clear? What they did, they taken an apparatus, the same conditions they provided in the lab which were proposed by Oparin and Haldane, and what they have taken, they taken a mixture of gases, NH3, H2, H2 and CH4 was taken in a flask, and there was the supply of cold water as well as the vacuum was created, and U-tap was there from where the product was taken out, and the electrodes were present to provide the like the same electric charge as the life threatening. Okay. The answer is A. So moving to the question number 5. Moving to the question number 5. All the examples of analogous, homologous. Okay. And divergent evolution, convergent evolution. Very, very, very important. Especially the examples. Every example should be learned, should be on your tips. Because most of the time from this chapter, they have just taken the example. Sometimes now, from few years, the question, like if three questions are there, then the two questions are coming logically from the various theories, like theories, Darwinism and Neo-Darwinism, and the various genetic drift, founder effect, bottleneck effect, combination, mutation, the effect of tri-specific competition. All these logical things in which are present in various theories, surely one or two questions are coming from there directly. Okay, so you need to go for all these theories also. Forelimbs of cat, lizard used in walking, forelimbs of whale used in swimming. So what they are giving, that the structure is same but functionality is different. When the organs having the similar structure, they originally they are same. Okay, these are same, but they are performing different functions. Then these are known as homologous organs. And this type of evolution is known as, who is going to write? And this type of evolution is known as who's going to write the answer? Come on, guys. When they are diverging to different directions or radiations, but they have a common origin, same body plan they have, embryonic development they have, but they are adapted to perform different functions, then this type of evolution is known as, this is for your recap of the chapter. That's why the rapid revision series are very, very important. By this rapid revision series, you are assuming that I am weaker in this portion, in this subtopic, I am not able to recall the answer in minutes. Then you have to go back to revision. Just now, on the same day, give 1 hour to the revision and have a proper. Yes, this is a divergent evolution and adaptive radiation. Okay. So the answer here is homologous organs. Organs which have a common fundamental anatomical plan and similar embryonic origin, whatever various functions they may perform are regarded as homologous organs. Like the flippers of a whale, a bat's wing, forelimbs of a horse, a bird's wing or forelimbs of human are structurally as well as functionally different. Classic period of Mesozoic era is characterized by. So here they are talking about the era, and in era of Jurassic period, Triassic, Jurassic, is characterized by. We see the Cretaceous, that is for the flowering plant, angiosperm. So Jurassic period, it is characterized by which of the following option? Gymnosperm were prominent, or the radiation of the reptiles, dinosperm, dinosaurus, some extinct, flowering plant, no, but not in Jurassic period. What should be the answer? So you can see the different kind of questions are coming. You have to learn the whole chart. Era, your duty to learn this. If you have not learned the chart properly, go back to this period. Epoch, various learn this chart as it is. Angiosperm, where were angiosperm placed? No sperm, first reptiles. Okay, so what should be the answer? So the Jurassic period of the Mesozoic era, the gymnosperm were dominant and the first bird appear. So these kind of questions sometimes you can see in examination. So you have to learn this chart as it is from the book which you are following, or from the content which is provided, the continuity that has the very good chart there. Also the chart for the human evolution is there, which is very, very important to know. Okay, the answer for this is A. Okay guys, go back to your chart and learn this. You can see here this taken from NCERT only. So if you see, go to the period Jurassic, there are conifers, cycads. So the gymnosperm were prominent in this, and monocotyledons and dicotyledons, they were come later on the Cretaceous. So the Cretaceous is for the flowering plant. Okay guys, is it clear? Is it clear? The question number 6 is clear. Moving to the question number 7. Which of the following explain evolution is most acceptable form? Which of the following explained evolution is most acceptable form? In most acceptable. Lamarck, Darwin, Hugo de Vries, Anaximander, Darwin, Malthus, Afredi, Reicher and Huber, Lamarck and Hardy, Weinberg and Darwin. Jivita, Srividya, M. Karthi, Sritisha, Pooja, and all of you, I hope the 6th question was clear with you. Now you just try for the question number 7. Try for question number 7. You are not able to recall the things, go back to revision and today only. That is the suggestion. Give 1 hour and learn the things properly. 1 to 2 hours for learning. 1 to 2 hours. Give 1 to 2 hours. Answer question number 7. See the work. Like Hardy Weinberg, it was a principle which was given for the population. So they are applicable, but this is Hardy Weinberg is not going. Afredi, they were like the free theories which were given, Rich and Cuvier, so it is also not. Anaximander, Darwin, Malthus was a supporter, but the theories were not given by them. So the most importantly theories which were like betterly explained for the evolution, these were the theories given by Lamarck, Darwin and Hugo de Vries. The mutation theory was given by Hugo de Vries, Darwin, there was neo-Darwinism also. And Lamarck, and the modification of Lamarck was seen as neo-Lamarckism, which was followed by Darwin and Hugo de Vries. So the answer, it should be 1. Okay, for the 7th, the answer should be 1. Yes, Srividya and Jivita, this is the right answer, 7A. Okay, I hope all the theories clear with you, Darwin. Sorry, Lamarck and Hugo de Vries, they have a great contribution in explaining the evolution and the various evolutionary forms. But the most acceptable theory was the neo-Darwinism, or the modern theory of evolution was finally accepted. Which of the following statements is incorrect? Which of the following statements is incorrect? Life processes, I am going little bit faster because we have a number of questions and the time is running, so be quick in answering because it is a rapid fire series and also a practice for rapid revision or the rapid attempting of the question, but correctly. Life processes are consequences of reactions that occur in an organism. Living organisms are made of inorganic and organic compounds. Life comes from pre-existing life. Genes are not responsible for stability and changeability of species. If you see, read it correctly, first of all, incorrect. It is not asking about a correct statement, it is asking about a incorrect statement. So we know that without going, life processes, these are a consequence of reactions that occur in an organism's life. All the life processes, digestive process, circulatory process, excretory process, so many processes which are involved in this, these are responsible that occur in an organism, and these are the catabolic reactions as well as anabolic reactions, metabolism. Living organisms are made up of organic and inorganic compounds, this is also right. Okay, life comes from pre-existing life, omnicellula e cellulae. Okay, given in the first cell chapter of 11th as such. So, what should be the answer? Answer is D. D genes are actually responsible for stability or changeability of the species. These are the variations at the genetic level or the recombination in the crossing over, which is responsible for creating a new kind of species over a number of generations. So the answer for this question is D. Okay, all of you have given right answer. Very nice, everyone. Going to the question number 9. Going for the question number 9. The study of homologous structure in mature organisms provide evidence for the evolutionary relationships among certain group of organisms. Which field of study includes this evidence of evolution? So various kind of evidence. Question is asking about the evidences. So many type of evidences are present, like the evidences from biochemistry, evidences from fossils, evidences from cytology, evidences from different geographical areas, yes, atavism, vestigial organs, what are all these, homologous organs, analogous organs, okay. So these are what, these are the evidences which support the evolutionary process. So the homologous structures and analogous structures comes in which category? There is one is the histology, another is the anatomy. Another one is the anatomy. We talk about the structures. Others, please respond. Give your answer and be quick in answering your question. Be quick. Amis and yes, it is 9D. It is comparative anatomy. Both analogous and homologous structures study comes into the comparative anatomy. Okay, is the answer is D. Artificial selection to obtain cows yielding milk, high milk output. Artificial selection to obtain cows. They are talking about a cow which are artificially selected. So there is natural selection, this is artificial selection, but for a high milk output variety. Okay, we are talking about a cow variety which is giving a high milk output. Okay, how lactation is there, what it represent? Stabilizing selection, directional, disruptive, or the stabilizing followed by disruptive, what should be the answer? Whole process shifted. There are three type of selection process. One, stabilizing. Second, directional. Third, formation of a two kind of. Okay. So why it is directional? Why it is, Shritisha, why it is directional? You are saying it is directional. That is a right answer actually, because whole directional selection, the whole of the graph or the pieces are adapted for the extreme, either left or extreme right. So it is not low yielding cows, these are the high. So whole mean of the character is shifted in one direction. So it is a directional selection. Okay, your answer is right. Answer is B here. If they talk about that both of the extremes are eliminated after a number of generations and we are getting a sharp peak, then it is stabilizing always. Okay, when shifted either in left or in right, then it is directional. Then there is formation of two different forms and elimination of the original form, then this is known as disruptive selection. Okay, the answer is B. Okay guys, is it clear? Everyone, show me your thumb if it is clear. If it is clear, you can show a thumb. And if you guys like the session, do like the video and you can also share in your peer group or in your friends. Is it clear? Question number 10. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 आई एम आस्किंग, इज इट क्लियर? यस, आंसर इज राइट. श्रीविता, जीविता, श्रीत्रिषा, व्हाट अबाउट द अदर्स? विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द करेक्ट सीक्वेंस ऑफ इवेंट्स इन द ओरिजिन ऑफ लाइफ? हियर दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सीक्वेंस ऑफ इवेंट्स. सीक्वेंस ऑफ इवेंट इज गिवन फॉर द ओरिजिन ऑफ लाइफ, दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द एटम्स वर प्रेजेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द आफ्टर द बिग बैंग कोलाइजन देयर इज द सेपरेशन ऑफ द पार्ट्स and there is and when the gases cool down there is the formation of different elements then the molecules after the molecules there are monomers yes this is the series after the monomers there are polymers like there were sugar proteins amino acids okay and after the formation of the polymers there was the formation of first living cell that was the protobionts And after the protobionts, there were the cells which were having a separate genetic system, and there was the formation of DNA also. So, what should be the correct sequence? First should be, second should be, third should be, and it should be fourth. So, where it is given, like second. Third, one and fourth. Is it the sequence? It's a sequence. So now what should be the answer? What should be the answer? These were the sequences in the origin of life. Don't have so much of time. So I have explained in shortly, but the whole series I have given you here. The answer is C, yes. Tanis, it is C. The answer is C. So see how important to read every subtopic very carefully. They can ask you question from anywhere, anywhere. So do have a proper revision. I am saying you again, and as I am meeting you after a time, so very important to go for the NCERT also, as well as with the whole of the content which is provided with you. And do a lot of practice. So question number 12. Given below are four statement A to D, each with one or the two blanks. Select the option which correctly fills up the blank in two statements. Given below are four statements. What you are seeing, guys, here A, B, C and D is given. Till here the statements are given. Okay. Now there are given the four choices. So what should come at the first place and second place? All things of butterfly and bird look like, and all the result of what? What should be the answer for question number 12? I am waiting. Things of butterfly and birds look alike. Type of evolution it is, convergent evolution is given in different choices. Here shows that CH4, H2, NH3 and so when exposed to electrolysis in a flask resulting in the formation leucocytes cannot. What should be the answer? D1, according to Darwin, evolution took place due to small variation. It is right. Second, survival of the fittest. It is also right. If we go for 12A, A first is the convergent evolution. The three choices in this given, we go for first choice only. The first choice is right. First choice is right. What happened, Jeevita, Akshaya? No problem. Take your time. Take your time guys. C for D, according to Darwin, evolution took place due to through small variations and survival of the fittest. Yes, according to Darwin's theory, there are small variations in this species and goes for survival of the fittest. One who is fittest will survive. Okay, because of the competition for the space and food sources. Second is given as the convergent evolution. Called convergent evolution. So it is, the answer is A. Answer is A. Yes, very nice. All of you have given the right answer. Answer is A here. Okay, guys. Question number 13. Be quick in answering. We have a number of questions and time is short. Arrange the periods of Paleozoic era in ascending order in a geographical time scale. So now you can see here in this question how important to learn that chart. Geological time scale is very, very important. Writing here. Geological time is very, very important. Okay, so they are asking about the periods which are present in. There is Cambrian, Devonian, Ordovician, Carboniferous and Permian. These are the different types. But in ascending order, like this. Okay, so which is at the top? Top is Cambrian. I am giving a clue. At the last, it is Permian. Just now we have gone. What should be the answer, guys? Turn the chart. Manage your time at home and learn the chart. It is very important to learn each and every diagram, each and every table. You cannot escape anything from any chapter because we don't know how, from where the question is coming. And you, all of you know, once you are understanding the chart that it is given, it is like era is given, period is given, or the epoch is given. You have to learn the things. What I am saying in every session. Also, the examples are present now in front of us that how important to learn the things. Understand the topic and it is Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous and Permian. Okay, so all of you have given the right answer. Since the answer is A. See here. Here it is only given from Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian. Side of this, there is Cambrian and Ordovician. Okay, the answer is A for question number 13. I am going to the question number 14 and I am not giving much time question because all of you know that fins, trails, tracks and tunnels of various organisms made in mud are rapidly filled in sand and covered with sediment, sedimentary rock. This is an example of which of the following type of fossils. There are petrified fossils are there, impressions are there, imprints are there and coprolites are there. We talk about the fossils, the type of fossils. There are four type of fossils give the evidence for the various kind of evidence. So which is sent in sand and covered by sediment? What are these? Buried inside. What are these? Be quick in answering your answer. Guys, we have a number of questions. Can give the time for us. This is I am waiting for the response. What are these? Sometimes this question has been asked many times in it also. What is the answer? I am waiting, guys. Any response? The answer is A. are the petrified fossils. Turn on impressions. Moving to the question number 15, go back to the type of fossils and have a revision. Question number 15, wings of a bird and wings of an insect. Very, very generally asked question from the evolution chapter. Very, very important. Question number 15, guys. Wing of a bird, wings of a bird and the wings of an insect are. Wings of a bird and the wings of an insect. Yes, all of you know, I know you know the answer. Are the analogous structures, and analogous structures, they show the convergent. They have different basic plans. Embryonically, development is different, but they are performing the same function. So from different origin, they are coming towards a single point because their function is same. They are converging towards a point. So this is the convergent evolution. Okay. As the origin is different, but they are performing the same. They are merging towards a single point. Converging, that is the convergent evolution. So the answer, it is B. Right answer, everyone. Question number 16. Question number 16. Question number 16. Match the following column 1 with column 2. Column 1, Darwin, Lamarck, Hugo de Vries, A.I. Oparin. So the name of the scientist is given here, and you know better that they must be talking about the theories they have given. The contribution of the scientist. Whose and diffuse theory was given by, like the example of giraffe. Inheritance of acquired characters. Origin of species, origin of life and the mutation theory. Mutation theory was given by Hugo de Vries. So what should be the answer for question number 16? I am waiting for the response. Darwin. A.I. Oparin. Origin of life. Mutation theory, Hugo de Vries. Third, it is C. First, it is C. Second, it is A. And fourth, it is C. Answer is D. 1B, 2A, 3D, 4C. Okay? The answer for the question number 16 is D. Going for question number 17. Evolution of different species in a given area, starting from a point and spreading to other geographical areas is known as. Example of Darwin's fringes. Various type of birds which were found by Darwin on the Galapagos Island. They have different type of beaks because they were adapted for different feeding habits. Pause an example of a. Or the example of Australian marsupial. Very, very important. And the diagram given in NCERT. NCERT in the tabular form also. Marsupials about here is given in tabular form, the color diagram, very very important. Learn. Again I am saying, so it is a adaptive radiation, very very good. Pollution of different species in a area, and they spread to different areas on the geographical areas, but they adapt in different eating habits, like in Darwin's finches, blackbird. So it is the adaptive radiation. Very nice. Question number, and this is also the example of ancestral marsupial. And another table which is given is very very important also. Very important. Question number 18. According to Darwin, the organic evolution is due to intra-specific competition, inter-specific competition, or competition within closely related species, reduced feeding efficiency in one species due to the presence of interfering. Origin of a new species from a species is because of the, what I said, I have given the clue. Origin of a new species from a original species is because of, should be because of interspecific or intraspecific competition. We cannot say here, we cannot go for closely related species. Okay. We have to go for specifically. Not be. Why interspecific competition? When they are living in an area, the members of the population can compete for the same space and the resources available. So it is a intra-specific competition. It is a intra-specific competition. Think about this. Interbreeding. Yes. The answer is A. Choose the wrong pair. Question number 19. Divergent evolution. The examples are given here. Divergent evolution for limbs of whales, bat, cheetahs and human. Convergent evolution, flippers of penguins and dolphins. Homologous structures, vertebrate heart. Analogous structure, tendrils of bougainvillea and cucurbita. Adaptive radiation, Darwin's. So adaptive radiation just now we have given on, that is fifth. Right. Homologous structure, vertebrates, heart. Convergent evolution is right. Divergent, as they have the same type of limbs but they are performing different functions, is also right. So what is remaining? This one is remaining. This is a wrong pair. These are actually the homologous organs. But who can give the reason for this? Who can give the reason for this? Why the bougainvillea and cucurbita? Why they are not analogous organs? Why 19D, Akshya, Srividya, wrong pair? Wrong pair. Is there any confusion? Adaptive radiation, Darwin finches is a prominent example. Last slide, only on last question I have given you the example of Darwin's finches for adaptive radiation. Read it correctly. Read the statement correctly, bacha. So you have to read or choose the wrong pair. So it cannot be a wrong pair. We know that tendrils of bougainvillea and cucurbita, they are the homologous organs. They have different functions. They perform differently. But both are present at the axillary position. They are homologous structures. Okay, and this diagram is as such given in the NCERT. Very, very important, all the diagrams. answer here it is fourth. Okay, yes. Here five. No. I am sorry. You have written 19-4. So I thought that one is the fourth one. Sorry guys. It is the right answer for 19-4. Yes. Shri Trisha, Shri Vidya, Akshya, Jivita, or Jivita. It is 19-4. Your answer is right, guys. Your answer is right. I'm sorry. 20th. Question number 20. A population of 1000 individuals, 360 belong to a genotype AA, 480 to AA, capital A, small a, and the remaining 160 to small a. Based on this idea, the frequency of allele A in the population. How you will get to know about the frequency of the allele A? Yes. Pita, it is 19. Yeah, I've moved question number 20. Yes, your reason is right. Question number 20. I want all of you to attempt this question so that I come to know that the principle is clear with you guys. P plus Q is equal to 1. How you will calculate the frequency? That is P square is equal to 3.6. Equal to this. Okay. Yes. This is 0.6. Okay, all of you. 20C right answer. Question number 21. Moving to the question number 21. The case of peppered moth, that is Bistan bitularia, the black colored form become dominant over the light colored form in England. We know that during the natural selection, it is an example, prominent example of natural selection. And industrial mannerism, the word which is used for this is the industrial mannerism. Okay, so this is an example of inheritance of darker color character acquired due to the darker environment. Natural selection, whereby the darker forms were selected. Appearance of the darker colored individual due to very poor light or the protective mimicry. So it is not a protective mimicry, not due to very poor sunlight. As I told you, it is a form of natural selection which happened in mid 90s in England during the Industrial Revolution. So all of the black light colored forms were eliminated and black colored forms were remained. So they were adapted or selected by the nature. The answer, yes, all of you have given very nice. This is 21B or 2. Okay. Question number 22. Variation in gene frequencies within population can occur by chance rather than by natural selection. As it is line from NCERT. And various questions. This is referred to as genetic flow, genetic drift, random mating or genetic load. What should be the answer for question number 22? Yes, it is 21B. Guys, try to respond for the question number 22. All of you have given the right answer for 21. Very good. Now moving. Variation in, you can see it is a direct question that the variation, all these things are given in the modern theory, mostly accepted, or the new Darwinism, you can say, or the neo Lamarckism, after the work of Lamarck, after the work of Codivaris, after the work of Darwin, there is the modern theory or the synthetic theory which was given to justify the organic evolution or the chemical evolution. C 22B. Chance elimination of the genes. The population because of any natural calamities, that is the genetic. Okay, the answer is B. Moving to the question number 23. Match the following. If you see this question, see it correctly. Might be like if these type of questions are coming. First of all, the chances of coming these questions are very rare. Either they will go for direct like Raymond Dart, what was the contribution? They will ask it. There are lesser chances to come in this because these are the extra things which are not given in NCERT. But the question has been asked about this in past year questions, past year exams. So these are important, but coming into this form that all of the options should be known by the learners, they are not coming. But discoveries, who discovered which form of human? Homo habilis, Neanderthal man, Cro-Magnon man. Why I am telling you? Because these type of question has been already asked. But their frequency is less, but they have already come in exam. So it is Pliocene, Richard Leakey, Mid-Pleistocene, Dusseldorf, and Raymond Dart. Here it is given that Sinanthropus pekinensis, Homo neanderthal, Homo habilis, Oreopithecus. So what is their contribution? Who can answer this question number 23rd? This is the packing man. Go by the general name. Okay. And it was discovered in mid-Pleistocene. And very prominently, the question which asked earlier was on Raymond Dart. He was involved in discovery of Australopithecus in Africa. So you can go by two things now. Second, you can eliminate this. Okay. Richard Leakey, he was the discoverer of Homo habilis. For the discoverer of Homo habilis. So you should learn this also and this also. And chances of coming this here, but as you can see, the question has been asked. You cannot give anything. So answer. Yes, these type of questions, generally they are not coming. But many times, the question like the discovery, on the basis of the discoverer, has been asked already. Like Raymond Dart, he was the discoverer for the Sinanthropus pekinensis, Perking man. The common name is Perking man in Africa. Pliocene, like here, the some period is given. Okay. Fock is given. And some discoverer name is given. What you are saying, there are some discoverer name and there are some epoch is given. So Raymond Dart directly, this is a direct question. If Australopithecus was discovered by Raymond Dart, Richard Leakey was involved in Homo habilis, and Dusseldorf Homo neanderthalis, Mid-Pleistocene Oreopithecus. So for this you have to learn the chart. Okay guys, here is the chart given, then it is Dryopithecus, Ramapithecus, Neanderthal man, Homo habilis, Homo handy man, Cro-Magnon man. So the common name and their cranial capacity. The question. So these type of questions are rare to ask, but as you can see, the question are coming. So if we go with this, A5th, B4th, C first, D third, E second. Okay? Okay, so the answer is given by you is correct. It is A. The answer is A. So what you have to learn in human evolution, which is again very important, cranial crepacity, must know. Today's man, direct ascender of today's man, Neanderthal man, Cro-Magnon man, and where they were found, like Shivalik hills in India, where they are involved. This type of question has been asked. Question for the 23, the answer is A. The process by which organisms with different evolutionary history evolve a similar phenotypic adaptation in response to a common environmental change is called. What should be the answer for question number 24? I am not giving the answer here. I am expecting that everyone giving the right answer. Question number 24. The process by which organisms have different evolutionary history, so their origin is not same. Read the statement correctly. Different evolutionary history, the meaning of different evolutionary history, their origin is not same. Evolve a similar phenotypic adaptation. Adaptation means they are performing phenotypically, externally they are performing the same function. Amis Azhagen, read the statement. That's why I am pausing in between. The process by which organisms with different evolutionary history evolve a similar phenotypic adaptation. I have given the NF of the clue. Response to a common environmental change is called. Similar phenotype means external. Adaptation means they are performing same function, but embryonically or originally they are different. Yes, it is a convergent evolution. Very, very nice. If we are not reading the statement, just looking at it, most 90% will go for adaptive radiation. They will not think about the convergent. So for attempting these type of questions, guys, we need to be very careful with the every word of the statement. Okay, are you understanding what I am saying? These type of questions are coming in NEET examination from last 10 years. You can see a number of questions logically on natural selection, type of natural selection, adaptive radiation, evolutionary form, convergent and divergent. There are two type of convergent evolution and divergent. Converse, they are converging towards similar function. That is convergent. Then they have similar origin, but they are diverging. That is divergent, to perform different functions. So there are two forms. For this is two. Right, very, very nice, who have given the B answer. But majority of the student, if they are not going with the words of the statement correctly, they will go for adaptive radiation. It will make a difference to your mark. Is it clear everyone? Question number 25. What is true about the isolated small tribal population? This is also a question from NEET 2006 or 16. I think 2016. If I am not wrong, what is true about the isolated small tribal population? Last question was understood by all of you. Pita, Akshya, Shritisha, Tamiz, Shritline, Pooja. Okay. What is true about the isolated small tribal population? There is a decline in population and boys marry girls only from their own tribe. Read the statement very carefully. What I was saying, these type of questions now are coming examination. So learn the modern theory very well. Modern theory, like genetic recombination is there, mutation is there, variation, Darwin's theory, very well. Go for this and have a revision, like reading, so that you can grab the topic, the principle behind to attempt these type of questions. Okay? Hereditary diseases like color blindness do not spread in the isolated population. Wrestlers who develop strong body muscles in their lifetime pass this character onto their progeny. There is no change in population size as they have a large gene. What is true about this? If we go for this, hereditary disease can pass from mother to son. So this cannot be right. Wrestlers who develop strong body muscle in their lifetime pass their character to their progeny. No, it cannot be. If a person is fat, so not necessary the progeny is going to be the fat. Okay, if we take the example, if a wrestler is having strong body muscles, is it not going to be passed? Like it is the same as the theory of acquired characters during the lifetime, but that was disproven. Okay, and there is change in population as they have a large gene. But so what should be the answer? Answer is A. There will be decline in population as the boy marry girls only from their own tribe, because the population is small here, very small isolated tribal groups which live in the forest or in jungles, and if they are going to marry the girls, there will be decline in the number. Okay. Question number 26. Select the correct statement from the following. Darwinian variations are small and directionless. Fitness is the end result of ability to adapt and get selected by nature. All mammals except whales and camels have 7 cervical vertebrae. Mutations are random and directional. What should be the answer for question number 26? I want to attempt all of you this type of questions. I am waiting for the response. Come on. No worries, in 10 minutes we will be ending this session. And my suggestion, if you are lacking in recalling the topic like geological time scale and human evolution, because what I am assuming from the answers given by all of you, you need to have a revision of these topics, might be both the topics, have a revision at home. Why it is 26D, Shri Trisha? I just want to know the reason. What according to the Darwin's theory, survival of the fittest. Survival of the fittest. One who is fit will survive to compete with the others or in a competition to get the resources and the space. I am giving you the hint also. So mutations are not random. These are random, but these are not directional. They are not directional. We go with the selection in the nature. Fitness is one of the major factors. One who is fittest will survive in the nature. It's okay, it's okay. Answer for the question number 26 is, what should be the answer, guys? Darwinism variations, small variation, but these are directionless. These are directional. First is given. Is B. Answer is B. Okay. Question number 27. Fossil of Cro-Magnon man. Cro-Magnon man. What is the name for Cro-Magnon man? Who is going to write? What is the another name for Cro-Magnon man? Scientific name. Cro-Magnon man. What is the another name? Scientific name from Cro-Magnon man. The name is given on the name of the discoverer, MacGeorge. So about Cro-Magnon man, what is the another name for Cro-Magnon man? Who is going to write? आई एम वेटिंग फॉर द रेस्पॉन्स. शिवालिक हिल्स इंडिया नीएंडरथल वैली, एज वी कैन नो दैट इट इज फॉर नीएंडरथल मैन. अफ्रीका, मैनी फॉर्म्स वर कवर्ड इन अफ्रीका लाइक पैकिंग मैन. फ्रांस, आंसर इज डी इज फ्रांस. को मैग्नन केव्स वर देयर एंड वॉट इज द नेम फॉर क्रो मैग्नन मैन एंड द क्रेनियल कैपेसिटी ऑल्सो हु इज गोइंग टू राइट विल बी ए वेरी वेरी गुड फॉर दैट. एक्सीलेंट. होमो सेपियंस फॉसिलिस. ओके, हैव ए रिविजन ऑफ ह्यूमन इवोल्यूशन, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड जियोलॉजिकल टाइम स्केल फ्रॉम द इवोल्यूशन चैप्टर. बिकॉज दीज आर द टू थिंग्स विच यू हैव टू लर्न लर्न लर्न. क्वेश्चन नंबर 28. अमंग द ह्यूमन एंसेस्टर्स द ब्रेन साइज वॉज जीविता. इट इज नॉट ए, इट इज बी फ्रांस. क्रो मैग्नन केव्स फ्रांस. ओके, ब्रेन साइज वॉज मोर देन 1000 सीसी इन. ब्रेन साइज वॉज मोर देन 1000 नीएंडरथल्स. होमो इरेक्टस, रामा पिथेकस, होमो हैबिलिस. यस श्री त्रिशा, वेरी गुड. इज 1400 टू 1700. वेरी गुड श्री त्रिशा. क्वेश्चन नंबर 28. क्वेश्चन नंबर 28. अमंग द ह्यूमन एंसेस्टर द ब्रेन साइज वॉज मोर देन 1000. Yes, I am waiting for others to respond. Yes, it is Homo Neanderthalensis and it is like 1400 CC. All of these have, so these like Erectus 900, it is 600 to 800. Ramapithecus not given. The answer is A for the question number 20. During development, mammalian heart is initially two-chambered, then three-chambered, and finally four-chambered. So, for explanation of these kind of phylogenetic development, one law was given. What was that law? Ontogeny recapitulates phylogeny. Capitulates phylogeny was the statement which was given for the law. Means that the embryonic development of an individual repeats all its ancestors in succession they are, and it is the phylogenetic law which was given by Ernest Haeckel and Muller. Okay, so biogenetic law was given by Ernest Haeckel and Muller in 1868. This is also known as Haeckel's law. And I am very happy to see that all of you know about this. Moving to the question number 38, which is the last question of this session. Before attempting this question, I want everyone to have a revision of human evolution. Hey guys, I want to have a revision of modern theory, all the parameters. Okay, and third is the geological time scale, so that your chapter should be complete. Every terms, every example, every diagram from the NCRT, every table from the NCRT is very, very important. We are having a proper revision, that these kind of sessions are very, very good for you. Okay? Okay, everyone. Which of the following is not true for a species? Question number 30th. Members of a species can interbreed. Gene flow does not occur. Not true. Read it correctly. between the populations of a species. Each species is reproductively isolated from every other species. Variation occur among members of a species. Yes. See the answer. See the answer, guys. They can interbreed. There should be the gene flow. Yeah, reproductively isolated. Reproductive isolation is there. Variation occur among members of a species. That's why over a number of generation there is the formation of a new species. Okay, all these things are interlinked. The answer for the question number 30th, it is B. Very, very good, all of you. So only two or three questions were there in which you were having little bit of difficulty. And these questions were from the geological time scale and from the human evolution. So I want you have a learning and as well as learn so that you can retain it. There should not be confusion. If you learn the things properly, give the time, learn, you will not have any confusion in attempting any kind of question. Okay. Is it clear, everyone? I want a big thumb if this session is very, very good for you or beneficial for you. We are having another rapid revision series. Have a revision for coming to the class so that it Akshya, Srividya, Pooja, Jeevita, and Tamiz, and it is the 9. I hope it is clear with you guys. We are meeting for day after tomorrow for the another session. Have a revision at home. Do hard work. Give your time for every subject. See what are the subtopics which you are lacking and give your time to that on the same day. Okay, on the same day. So that you can retain it properly. Do a lot of practice. Lot of practice and NCERT reading for attempting biology 350 plus. Very, very must. Okay, thank you so much, guys. I am winding this session. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day. Do study hard.